I remember back in our day, man, see, I grew up in the early 70s, late 60s. Where the 70s babies at? Where y'all at?
See?
Dude. See, we don't want, see, we in a good spot, because we still in that, we ain't too old to kick it, but you ain't young enough to be stupid still. You know? We right in that little cool ass, I know who I am mode now, but you almost too old to still keep hanging at the fucking club. Your time is ticking. You better hurry that shit up. You know, still young enough to screw a 20-year-old, but too old to ask her to dance. That kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? You gotta know your limits. Because a couple more years, you're gonna fuck around and miss your window. You'll be that motherfucker standing in the club by yourself looking stupid, pants up too high like you recognize the song. Fuck over here. Shit right there, huh? Acting like you know the song. You ain't never heard of that shit. Ah, right there, that's hot. Be doing that George Jefferson and shit. You know you ain't dancing with nobody with that shit. And you be trying to play it off, go up to the DJ and ask for some shit like you up on what's cracking. You go up giving yourself away. Excuse me, dog, you got that peaches and herb? Yeah, put that on for me. Put that on for me. Look at See, you look at the 50%ers leaning over the rookies going, who is peaches and herb? It ain't out yet. Go ask for it next week. You rookies. Back when we was growing up, see, we had real stuff, man. We had them hardcore toys. We had shit you had to work to play with when we was little. I ain't lying. We had shit like a sit and spin. Remember that bullshit? Oh. Whew, that was a workout on that bastard. See, for those of you rookies that ain't old enough to know what I'm hollering about, let me break it down for you with the 100%. It was a big-ass piece of plastic that you spin around on till you got dizzy and fall the fuck off. That was entertainment in 69. Then they painted a stripe on it like it was high tech. Like didn't come with no directions or nothing. There wasn't shit else you could do with it. Even retarded kids can figure it out. Like, oh, I'm gonna sit down and spin around on this shit right here. And you spun in a circle, that was it. That was as high tech as it got. I bought my nephew one last year thinking I was gonna be retro and shit. He come downstairs with an attitude. He run up on it like, hey, huh? What this do? I'm like, it don't do shit, you do it. Motherfucker, push, pull, go. Shit, when you throw up, you through playing with the shit. That's what it do. Shit. It make you hot and sleepy, that's what it do. The kind of shit parents like. Motherfucker, make you dizzy enough to take a nap for about an hour. Shit. Serious, man. Then we had the kind of shit, we used to get bamboozled on the commercial because we didn't know about camera tricks in the 70s. And we didn't know they was actually stopping the commercial, moving the G.I. Joe and shit. We thought that motherfucker was actually running. I'm like, God damn, I got to have that, daddy. Woo, the army man got his, he walk and run and he be punching motherfuckers. I need that. I ain't lying, the biggest commercial that fucked us up though was that fucking Slinkies. Ooh. Duh, you know what I'm talking about. Damn, that shit was a bamboozle to the third degree. I ain't lying, man, that little white boy on the commercial got his Slinky going down the steps. Following his ass to school, eating breakfast with him and shit. I'm like, damn, that's a high-tech piece of wire right there. Daddy, put that on the list. I got to have that. I don't know how to spell it. SL, inky, whatever. Shit. That's some hot shit. I need that. Man, I got my Slinky home. It wouldn't do shit. I'm reading the instructions like I done fucked it up. I'm pushing it down the steps. It's just falling. I'm like, damn. Come to find out, my shit wasn't even really a slinky. My daddy done bent up a hanger and put it in a box and shit. Trying to play it off. Like, I didn't know slinkies was brown, daddy. Boy, that's the platinum edition. Going outside, going outside. You the only one that got that one. They ain't even here in the States yet.
Nigga, see.
I mean, I had one of them daddies that liked to get the hookup on everything, though. He didn't like paying full price for shit. So then none of my toys come from the store. All my toys came from my brother Trunk on 3rd Street named Earl. I thought Santa Claus' real name was Earl for the first 10 years of my life. Like, Santa Claus' name is Earl Kringle. I figured it out. My daddy always had the hookup, man. They used to piss us off, though, because when you're younger, you don't want no hookup shit. You want the real shit from the store and the commercial. You buying me no damn grocery store gym shoes, you bastard. Wonder why the fuck I'm flunking gym, motherfucker. Because I can't get no grip, daddy. Half this F is yours, punk. Shit, I'm a good-ass athlete if I could get some grip. We playing dodgeball, I'm the first motherfucker out every day. Everybody else scrambling, I'm running in one spot and shit. Like Fred Flintstone. Didn't have the nerve to give me some of them cheap-ass grocery store socks to go with it. Kind of come about 1,000 in a pack and shit. Pull them up, they come up to the nuts. Got about 12 stripes going down and shit. Nigga, I'm standing in gym class looking like Dr. Seuss and shit. Nigga, I'm 6 years old with these long-ass socks on. Then that was back in the day when you had to wear them little tight-ass gym shorts with the V on the side. I'm in school looking like a straight biatch. Got a little tiny-ass tank top my brother done handed down to me. Look like I'm about to do a strip show in this motherfucker.